Human resources, just where I needed to go.
Stone Cold looking for the director of human resources.
There you guys are. I'm looking for you. Hey, I'm digging the power tie there, Chief. Let me get a good look at that. Beautiful. You got the cutout going. You might have some potential.
That's Matt DeLuca.
Well, I'm going to introduce myself. Stone Cold Steve Austin, CEO. You are what? And what do you do?
My name is Sarah. I'm the human resources specialist.
Sarah, human resources specialist. Let me see what we can do here. Sarah, why don't you use your resources and go get old Stone Cold a couple of cold beers?
Excuse me?
Let me tell you what we have here. This is an orientation manual. Do you understand that? What I want you to do with this is to memorize it front to back. Back to front, I want you to know the direction that this company is going in. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
Because you know what might happen? You know what might happen? I might come back and quiz you today, tomorrow, whenever, about the contents of this manual. Something easy, like, let me see, start you off with something basic, like, here we go, we'll do this one. Austin 316 says...
I know that one.
Well, give it to me, kid.
I just whooped your...
It's okay. Go ahead and say it. I'm telling you, CEO, I'm giving you permission. Profanity is allowed here. Austin 316
what?
Says...
I just whipped your...
Don't say it.
...ass.
Oh, my... There's a brown noser for you, JR.
You got to work on your attitude, son. You'll come from here. Austin 316 says...
I just whipped your ass.
See, I knew you had some potential, kid. Now, do you know where I counted you?
Right down the hall.
I'm going to lead the way.
Look at this. What a brown noser. Look at the beak on this guy. Look at the swagger now.
Matt DeLuca's got an attitude.
Oh, my.
It's right this way, Steve.
That's it?
Right in here.
I think it's in here, Tiger.
Crazy son of a bitch.
All right, Chief, how you doing?
Good, good.
This accounting, am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So the numbers go on the pieces of paper, everything like that, right?
This is the place.
I want to see some books.
Books?
Which set of books did you want to see?
How many books you got? Just give me some damn books so I can look at some numbers here.
Which set? How many sets are there?
See what we got. Let's see what we got. Beautiful. I'm not an accountant, but I'm smart enough to see what's going on here.
Okay.
What's the deal with a lot of big numbers here? How come they're written in red?
Well, those are losses.
Losses?
Yeah.
Well, while we got losses, we need to be making money here, and I know we're making money. Why are these losses?
Well, unfortunately, we've had a few losses from some incidents you were involved in over the past
like
year.
What?
Well, there was the Zamboni incident, and the limousine incident, and the beer truck, and the
nah,
house.
Yeah. Enough already. Let's go into some different figures here.
Okay.
That's a hell of a figure there. What's the story on that?
Well, that's Vince McMahon's salary.
Somebody's just making that much money?
Well, he does all right.
I guess he does. I'll tell you what I want done. Take a couple of these zeros and put them behind Mick Foley's salary because the son just needs a little help with his medical bill.
What?
You understand me?
We can do that.
Let's move right along here.
You can't do that, Kenny JR.
Yeah, here we go. That's a good number. What's the bill on that?
Well, that's Shane McMahon's salary.
Shane McMahon is making that kind of money?
Yes.
I'll tell you what we want to do. We want to change Shane McMahon's salary, just scratch that off. We want that. That is now the beer budget.
The beer budget?
We don't have a beer budget.
You said what?
And that earlier today, our cameras, there you see it. This is a shot of Mr. McMahon's office. And King, will you look at all the plaques?
It's the most beautiful office I've ever seen.
It is. McMahon's got a shrine to himself, for God's sakes.
He earned all those awards.
Oh, look at it. Self-serving. He's got his picture everywhere. Vince McMahon, honorable Vince McMahon.
He's a humanitarian.
That's an oxymoron in itself. And look at this. He was responsible for production.
Double platinum. He's a philanthropist. I mean, this guy, look at that.
And that's before the facelift. And I don't understand this. He's got all, this is all before, the way it looked before Stone Cold arrived.
You see, Vince, after spending the entire day going over the day-to-day operations, the new CEO of the World Wrestling Federation has determined that what you need here is just a little more bullshit. Because what? I've been walking around in it all day, I might as well be swimming in it. I got a little something for you.
What's he doing, JR? How many beers has he
drank?
All in moderation. Oh, look at
you
this.
Urban boys, bring that shit in. Bring it on in, boys. It's something that's...
What
whole
is
room
this?
Is full of bullshit.
That's JR!
Get out of the way, son. Come on, bring your bullshit in. Come on.
I want to find out in Oklahoma.
See, this is exactly what I think about you and your little
cover.
Stone Cold Steve Austin, don't spare no expense. We'll let in. Damn, come on, boys. I said bring in some more bullshit. We got a good pile here, but this ain't good enough for Mr. McMahon. Bring it on in.
The flies.
Yeah, double on the rest of his pile.
Dung beetles.
The bottom line is, Vince, this place smells like shit.
Vince, get out of here. Oh, look, now Stone Cold. He's pouring beer on it.
I bet it's high quality cow manure. Well, the McMahons are headed our way. after Vince has just seen his office filled with cow manure, thanks to Stone Cold Steve Austin.
We're going to see some retaliation now. This is going to be good.
How are the McMahons going to react?
How are they going to retaliate?
And who are they going to take it out on? Oh, there's going to be some repercussions. Maybe Austin stipulations are coming next. And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Vince and Shane McMahon on their way out here now. And back at the ranch, Stone Cold Steve Austin has had cow manure poured all over Vince McMahon's office. Well, can you imagine the stench?
You mean BS? I mean, this is awful. Yeah, I can imagine the stench and the flies and the dung beetles. And I can't imagine what Vince McMahon and Shane are going to do about this.
The rattlesnake has pushed the McMahon men folk right to their limit. Look at the look on Shane and Daddy's face tonight. They're not happy.
Well, I'll tell
you. Remember, they're going to wrestle Stone Cold or fight Stone Cold 2-on-1 at the King of the Ring in less than 2 weeks.
You heard what Vince said. The only thing worse than Stone Cold being the champion is Stone Cold being the CEO of the WWF. Oh, look at that. Get that sign down, you idiot.
Maybe we're going to get those stipulations for the handicap match at the King of the Ring here. It's about time. It's upset.
I guess.
Austin. Stone Cold, you have disgraced the World Wrestling Federation with your mere presence in that beautiful edifice of the World Wrestling Federation World Headquarters. Austin, I won't forget and I won't forgive what you've done on this day. But hear this, Austin. We can't wait for the opportunity when you no longer will be the CEO. So this is our challenge, Austin.
Uh-oh.
We take this CEO title of yours. We take Shane's stock in the company. We take Vince's stock in the company. And you take all of that and you hang it. You hang it above a ring at the King of the Ring. And the only way to reach up and grab it all, Austin, is by climbing a ladder.
Oh, no.
That's right. Austin versus Shane and Vince in a ladder match, Austin.
Yes!
That's the stipulation.
Wow!
With only one other stipulation, by the way, to come tonight.
What's that mean?
And that relates to you, Rock.
Oh, okay.
If you can be victorious in your match this evening with The Undertaker, then Rock, you will have your title shot at the King of the Ring.
It's a promise.
However, remember that very special stipulation, Rock.
What is it?
And that stipulation for tonight.
Hey, wait a minute.
That's Shamrock's music.
Get out.
Shoot out. Here comes Shamrock.
Close.
Here comes Shamrock.
Get away out again.
Shamrock on Shane. Shamrock's suplex is Shane. And Vince McMahon is running for his life.
Get away, man.
Shamrock is chasing McMahon right out of sight.
Shane's hurt. He's hurt bad.
What's going to happen next when The Undertaker meets The Rock? Ladies and gentlemen, here's what happened moments ago. Ken Shamrock shocked us all, but no one more than the McMahons. And watch Vince McMahon. He shoved Shane right into Shamrock's arms.
He did not.
Watch this.
Look at this. Vince is about to lunge at Shamrock.
Give me a break. Shane
was inadvertently in the way.
Vince used his own son as a shield.
Oh, come on.
And Shane got suplexed for the effort.
Vince was about to tear Shamrock's head off.
And that's why he's loving Shamrock into false senses of security here.
I got the door. Just drive. Go.
He looks like a bank robber on a getaway.
Huh?
Huh? What did you go lose your train of thought there? This one are no part of Shamrock. He will have Shane back.